Hi everyone, I'm Dust Bunny Avenger of Slackers Undercover, and this, shortly, will be Fugue in Void. Huge thank you to Sadak LLC for granting us the opportunity to experience this. I'm looking forward to the trip. Now before I begin, you might be asking yourself, what is a fugue? Webster's offers two definitions. For one, a fugue can be in musical composition, a melody that is additive and intertwined with other parts to further develop it as a whole. A fugue is also one of loss, of awareness of one's identity, accompanied by, at times, hysteria or confusion. Now, with that being said, commentary will be kept to a minimal. Fugue in Void is an experience to deliver an artistic vision into the creator's mind. It's a casual, immersive journey that you gotta take some time on, and I intend to do just that. Now, if you're looking for a review of Fugue in Void, please refer to the timestamp listed in the description below. It will be at this video's conclusion, and the timestamp will take you right there. You won't have to see any of the gameplay, and I'll try to keep away from spoilers in the conclusion. That way, if you want to just get an idea of what someone else's thoughts on the video, on the game is, you can get an idea without, you know, spoiling the possible experience for yourself. Alrighty, everyone, let's begin.
Thank you. Thank you.
Fugue and Void's immersive experience wasn't quite what I had expected. Dark stone hallways echo your footsteps. Flickering lights, baleful sounds, and strange, yet wonderfully disturbing scenes pepper your surreal journey through the unknown. Several times I caught myself feeling uneasy, traversing a room, cautiously checking my surroundings, anxiously awaiting the inevitable creature lurking in the shadows to make itself known. Now, fortunately, I never encountered such a creature, but my imagination continued to wander as I ventured further into Fugue's abstract fantasy. Room to room, no obvious cohesion met my gaze. However, upon a second playthrough, I am reminded that this is the story of the creator's mind, or perhaps even a visualization of it. You gain control of your character on a thin path in the middle of the ocean, entering an intimidatingly vast structure, symmetrically sound, architecturally solid, surrounded by what seems to be an endless ocean of possibilities and darkness. And the deeper you delve, the more abstract and fantastical the adventure becomes, from pulsating quasars, shifting walls, to wireframe light shows and surprisingly frightful groans, as if the further you travel, the more you slip into a whirling creative madness, until finally, a peace, a calmness, a sanctuary within the chaos. Perhaps I'm reading into this more than I should, or maybe I'm not reading into it far enough. You tell me. Feel free to share your thoughts in the comments below. But on a personal note, it struck a chord. Now, I'm an insomniac by nature. I'm sure you're thinking, like, well, what's that got to do with? I can't sleep at night, because my mind is in a constant state of flux. All of my creative processes happen before bed, as a way to calm the madness within. The whirlwind of what goes through your mind can be stunning. It's just so much going on at a time, and it's really hard to put any of that into focus. And frankly, I applaud the creator for being able to formulate a visual representation of it. It's challenging taking what swirls in your noggin and giving it form, but this I can see, or in the least, what I interpret as what they might have been going for, as a mind, a fortress, perhaps even a prison, maintaining the madness, the creative insanity within, and that's kind of what this game was going for. The story of the mind, story of the creator's mind, rather. Like I said, maybe I'm reading into this way too much, but you know, that's the thing with art. It's always a matter of perspective, both from the creator and from those who view it. Although I enjoy the experience of Fugue and Void, I'm almost reluctant to recommend it. It is an art form, an abstract, a journey. Those describe it well. However, it's hard to say it's a game, because frankly, it's as much of a game as a canvas is a painting. It's a medium to deliver a story and nothing more. I suppose that's just hand in hand with what a walking simulator is. Not really a game, just a medium to deliver an idea or a concept. So please keep that in mind when considering this for yourself. The replayability is low. You might play it once, you might play it a second time just to kind of get an idea of what you saw the first time, kind of like what I did, but you know, it's to each their own. You know, perhaps you'll like it. All of the information will be listed in the description below their store page on Steam. I believe the game is $5.99 on Steam right now. I'm Dust Bunny Avenger of Slackers in the Cover. This was Fugue in Void. For more news and information, check out the description below. If you like what you saw and want to see more like it, slap that like button and subscribe. Join the underground family. Until next time, folks, later underground.